now the top issue concerning Americans. According to the Gallup organization, 28% of those polled said they're more concerned about immigration than government and the economy. And a record high 55% say large numbers of migrants entering the United States illegally are a great threat to this country. Well, joining us is Young Voices commentator and writer for The Spectator, Juan Pablo Villasmil. Juan, you recently wrote an article for The Spectator discussing the threat of migrant criminal Venezuelan gangs in the United States, Tren de Aragua. So how concerned should we be about them and why?
Yeah, so for a lot of time, we've been talking about some countries not sending their best. And in this case, just like it happened with MS-13, this gang is pretty notorious in Venezuela. And I saw that not a lot of people were diving deep into what this gang does and what it's known for. And the reality is that in New York City, NYPD has already determined that there is a presence of the Tren de Aragua in the city. And as we see crime spread throughout the United States, many of them being brutal crime, a lot of people are asking themselves, how many members of the Tren de Aragua are already inside the United States? That's not to say that all immigrants are Tren de Aragua members, but maybe many of them are, and that's a problem.
Well, how about these guys that beat up the New York Police Department police there, the cops there? There were like six or seven of them involved in that, and they were let go.
Yeah, they were let go, and there's a lot of videos online. If you search for them, you'll find them, of these people being interviewed, and they say, thank you, Joe Biden, for having us here. We're so happy to be here. And then they turn around and they commit crime. They're not the best. They're not the best people. And I say this as a Venezuelan American. Some of those Venezuelans are not the type of Venezuelans that people in Venezuela like.
Many of our viewers remember the Mariel boat lift, the mass immigration of Cubans that made that short but treacherous ocean journey from Cuba to Florida during Jimmy Carter's presidency in 1980. And some of those migrants were criminals released from prison by Fidel Castro. So how likely, again, do you think the Venezuelan president, Maduro, is weaponizing migration and doing the same thing?
It's complicated to tell because there's this facade of government in Venezuela. So a lot of the times they are in touch with cartels. There are connections between government officials and the gangs. Actually, the reason why this gang took control of a prison a la Pablo Escobar, and they had a restaurant and a nightclub in the prison, and then Maduro sent troops to fight against them. But before that, there was a policy of not doing anything about it for years. Like, just imagine this in the U.S. A gang takes control over a prison, and the government does nothing for like 10 years. And then they take it back, or they try to take it back, you know? It's really weird what happens in Venezuela. And it's not really clear if the government's directly behind this or if the gang is acting independently. But if you ask me, I assume that this immigration wave, this massive one for sure, must have other actors behind it. And I wouldn't be surprised if the Maduro regime is the one pulling the strings.
Okay, of course, this Gallup poll was taken a few days before the murder of nursing student Lakin Riley, allegedly by Venezuelan migrant Jose Ibarra. Now, that murder was front and center during Donald Trump's border visit last week. He's even released a new campaign ad highlighting the tragedy. Let's take a look.
Following some breaking news out of Athens, Georgia.
Two colleges have canceled classes today as police look for a murderer.
Lakin Riley was described as a shining light.
The Dean's List nursing student.
Police arrested 26-year-old Jose Antonio Ibarra.
Ibarra crossed into Texas illegally back in September of 2022, then was released into the United States on parole.
Riley's mother said her daughter's murder was avoidable. So you're a member of Gen Z. How effective do you think this ad is with younger voters? Does it get their attention? Do they even care about the border and illegal immigration?
I think younger voters care. The only thing I would say is that it's maybe more effective with the older generations, but not necessarily because Gen Z, Zoomers are an impenetrable market who will not digest, understand, and respond to this message. But it still seems like a message that parents and not their children are more susceptible to, because I think older folks understand the effects of immigration better, if that makes sense.
Okay, yeah, it does make sense, and I think we'll see how this plays out. It's going to be top and center, the big issue for campaign 2024. Okay, Young Voices commentator, writer for The Spectator, Juan Pablo Villasmil. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate it.